At the moment, this country is pretty much in a constant state of flux over how immigrants get here and how they're treated when they do. But you don't have to go back very far to find what was a quite shameful episode in our migrant history. Right up until the 1970s, thousands of British children were shipped here, many to be treated as virtual slaves with beatings, even sexual assaults. Now adults, they're suing. And leading the charge is an old mate of mine, the former boss of the ABC and Soccer Australia, David Hill. David, I should point out that we've known each other for quite a while.
A long while.
I thought of you as a, if you won't take this the wrong way, just another orphan. But it's much more complicated than that. You are one of the people you describe as the forgotten children. To somebody who doesn't know anything about this, who are the forgotten children?
Britain is the only country in history that exported very large numbers of its very poor children. And contrary to popular belief, we weren't orphans. We were just poor.
Right.
And for the best part of a century, there were these child migrant schemes that brought the poor kids out from England, largely to train boys to be farmers and girls for farmers' wives. And we were put on these farm schools. And it's a very recent phenomenon because about 10,000 kids came to Australia under these schemes. And the last one closed down in 1980. So
That's almost unbelievable that was going on.
It is.
So recently.
Mine closed in 1974. We were promised a decent education, but none of us got it.
It's almost Dickensian.
It is. Well, these were designed almost in Dickensian times, these schemes. And everybody had to leave school just about at the minimum school leaving age of 15. I did. And we were supposed to work the farm because these farm schools were almost totally self-sufficient in food. We did our own kill. We baked our own bread, we grew our own fruit and vegetables.
Suggestions, as if your book is right, which you've written, and other people's suggestions are right, brutality, beatings, sexual abuse.
That's where it went awry. The promise was the kids would be better off, and the promise wasn't kept. I'm one of the lucky ones, because I was 12, nearly 13. I was much older than the average.
You had a bit of an idea of what was going on.
And I had a twin brother and an older brother, so I had a couple of people looking out for me. And I was only there 3 years, and most importantly, I had a mum who followed us out.
Right.
The typical kids in these child migrant schemes, some of them as young as four, sent out to the other side of the world and put on a train and taken to the bush, spent their entire childhood and never saw their mum again.
So why now, David? Why this court case? Because I think, as you've said, you can't buy back compensation.
That's right.
You can't buy back children's or people's childhoods.
They were saying in court this morning themselves, you can't undo the terrible things that happen to these kids. I mean, holding six-year-old girls' head down a toilet to cure them of bedwetting. Whipping little kids with riding crops. All this is in government reports.
So
at the time.
What do these people want out of it now? The people's
recognition.
Class
they've had this hidden, disgraceful, shameful secret. They thought it was only happening to them.
Right.
They realised it was happening to a lot of other kids. Now there's a collective strength, and I think now they want most of all recognition that their childhood was taken from them and terrible things happened to them. That most of all.
David, good to talk to you.
Good to see you, George.
Horrible subject, but good to talk to you.
Yeah, it's good seeing you, George.